وقفات مع عامر.
حياكم الله وهلا بكم. الفنون فنون، لغة العالم كله يتكلم عنها، لكن سبحان الله الأجمل لما ننعكسها كل فنان وفنانة طريقته الخاصة. فنانتنا اليوم تميزت برسم بطريقة مختلفة عن الفنانين المعتدين اللي نشوفهم. الفنون نشوفهم دائما يرسمون بالريشة، بالقلم، بالسكين، مجسمات 3 دي ماكس، لكن ضيفتنا اليوم هتشوفوا حاجة مختلفة بإذن الله تنال إعجابكم. ضيفتنا الفنانة التشكيلية فيني في. Good day, Miss Vivi. How are you, Vinny?
Fine.
You have something unique. We always say art is a global culture. We always talk about unique things for art. We've seen something unique. Whoever is following you on Instagram, you know who is Vivi. But let's, before we start on that, let's get a background on how you start your painting culture education.
Actually, from my childhood itself, I started painting. Like, I can't remember. My mom told me that I started like 3.5 years.
Mm-hmm.
So in my school days also, I will participate in competitions and like watercolors and all those things. And on those days, in our schools, there were a lot of programs in art, like pencil drawings, paintings and all. So our school drawing teacher will take us to those places. So from there itself I started my painting.
Mm-hmm. India is a big country, so the competition for the art and artists is a humongous. Where did you even find herself as an artist type?
Actually, I did my first exhibition in 2011, so I did pen art. So at that time pen art was very less, so I did a whole exhibition with pen. So after the exhibition, my sir, he told me that we have to do something new and all those things. So I thought of new ideas and all, but still I didn't get it at that time. And then I started doing painting in my studio in our place. So sometimes as an artist, like everybody will be doing with their hands. Sometimes we will scribble and do. Sometimes it's like that. We will just scribble the paint with our hands.
Mm-hmm.
I think everybody will do like that.
Yeah.
So
not everybody. The majority goes with brush. You're doing it differently. Okay.
So I go by like I go like that. Mm-hmm. Like my fingers has gone like that. I was scribbling and doing the doing on the canvas. So I thought that it's a good idea. It's coming very nicely.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't need to. I was using oil paint, and I don't need to wash my. You know, sir. Actually, it's oil paint. It's a hectic thing is that we have to clean our brushes every time.
Of course.
With a turpentine and all. So I was scribbling with my fingers and it came nicely.
Hmm.
So I was very afraid to show other people that I'm doing finger painting. Nobody has done that one at that time.
She wanted to start in fingerprinting. جماعه الخير فنانتنا فيفين عشان بس متابعين لا يضيعوا معنا تبغى تبدا برسم مختلف. هي طبعا رسامه زي ما قلنا، لكن حابه تبتدي بطريقه مختلفه باليد. بالصباع. Please continue.
So I did a floral patterns and all over the canvas. When my friends came and when I showed them that this is my new work, I sent them photos and all. So everybody told me that this is a good thing and it looked like 3D, which is different.
Ms. Vinny, you have a unique art. But let's share with us where you studied your art school and from where you come up with that background.
Actually, after my graduation, I was doing pen art. I have done watercolors, acrylic, and every thing like oil also. But I want to do something different. So I did pen art first. So I did an exhibition in 2011. So after the exhibition, I thought that again. I have a thought that I have to do it different from this. Like from pen art, I have to do different. Like everybody was doing like watercolors, acrylic, everything with brush, palette knife was there. So I thought of doing something different. And I was having a studio in my home at that time. So I was practicing my art every day. So while doing on the canvas, I tried with acrylic first. It was going good. Then I was doing with oil paints. Actually, if you are doing oil paint, it's very hectic thing is that we have to clean the brushes every time.
That's
so,
right.
So otherwise we have to buy a new brush. So sometimes I will use my fingers to clear some part of my paintings.
Okay.
So I will be doing scribbling and all those things in my painting. While I was doing a poppy flowers or something like that, I was doing with the hands like round thing and all. So it came nicely. And I thought of doing some little bit background also with my fingers. So that time I was not wearing any gloves or something like that. I was using my bare hands. So
كانت بدايتها الفنانة فين الفكرة انه تبغى تنظف اللوحة من بعض البقايا من رسمتها سواء من الالوان زيتية او كليريك، بعدين بدأت بيدها الطبيعية تمسح او تشيل تحط بعض الرتوش عليها، فقررت انه تستعمل صوابعها الطبيعية تغيرا عن الريشة او السكين المتداولة. ف how's your fingers feels like؟ يعني you try to save the brushes but you're losing your fingers.
No, nothing like that. Actually, when we do with the fingers, it's not like there is no medium between me and my painting.
Okay.
Like when we are doing with brushes, there is a medium, like brush is there. So when we are doing with fingers, it's another thing, because we are touching it directly with our fingers. So if you are trying to do this one, you will have like relaxation feeling and all those things when you are doing this finger.
It's beautiful how you described your relation with your paint, and I really admire that. I really admire that. الجميل كيف وصفت تفاعلها وترابطها مع اللوحة، أنه لما تستعمل صوابعها على اللوحة نفسها فما في حواجز بينها وبين أعمالها. ما شاء الله عليك، ما أجمل ثقافة الفنون لما تكون فنانة فيفين جالسة ترسم لنا شيء من طباعنا من تراثنا اللي هو الجلسات البرية. Ms. Vivian, you've given us a beautiful art, part of our culture in Saudi or the Middle East in general. How do you share this with us?
Actually, when I came to Saudi Arabia, I have seen a lot of places here. Then I have met people over here. So when I'm talking to the Saudi people also, they will tell me about their culture and their so many things about them. So I like to listen to people when they are talking to me about their culture, everything. So that will be in my mind when I'm doing sketches and all those things. So when my husband, when he came here, he went to desert in the night and also he told me that people will come and they will sit like this and this is the thing they will have at night and all those things. Mm. So it will stuck in my mind. And I will, we will see, of course, everybody will see the like documentaries and all those things. So so I thought of doing something like this, like a fire in the night and all these things. So I did this one.
There's a big difference between living the act and imagining a photo.
Yes, yes.
When you see a photo, you start doing sketches,
yes,
to reflect it to a paint. When you live the act, when you go to the desert, you can feel everything. You can feel the sand feeling. You can feel the fire heat. You can feel the nature around you. How can you give us the feeling? There's so much details, so much feeling in this paint. It's like you've lived it. Now I'm surprised you're telling me you've never been there to desert.
Yeah, I have been to desert in Bahrain.
Okay.
Not here. In mm. Bahrain, I have been. Like, I will tell you one story that last time in my exhibition, I have done a big painting of walking through the palm trees.
Mm.
Like, it was big palm trees. And one camel is going with a rider. So the rider is going and so many bushes are there.
Mm-hmm.
And behind that, big palm trees are there. I just, in that painting, I use little bit surrealism also, to make it a little bit more beautiful. Like photography is different, the painting is different.
Of course.
Sometimes we have to add something more, not exactly, exactly like a photograph. So my father used to take us to this palm trees and all those, palm trees. So me and my sister will go with my father over there. Palm garden in Bahrain.
Mm.
So I will do sketching that time also. Sometimes I will take my sketchbook and I will go there.
Awesome.
So at that time, one camel was passing with a rider. So I just simply sketch it with a big palm trees. I just sketch the big palm trees and two birds were there.
Mm.
So I thought of the birds like talking to each other. So I was thinking that whether the bird is talking about the palm trees or about the rider, something like that. So it was like that. Sometimes.
So you're putting imagine into.
Yes. Sometimes,
sketches.
Yeah. That's why I told that sometimes I will talk to myself. It's a beautiful feeling when we are talking to like ourselves. So I will do every time like that, so that I will get that ideas to do something different, not the exact same thing.
ما هي الفنانة نبيل تقول لنا انه من خلال مشاعرها تتكلم مع نفسها عشان تحس بالواقع اللي هي فيه. وعطتنا مثال مسارة البحرين بالصحراء شافتها هي وابوها واختها. طبعا اللوعة هذه الله يجزيه خير زوجها هو اللي عيشها الدور لكن ما زارت صحراء السعودية. I was explaining to our viewers that you never join us in Saudi desert. That you should, your husband should take you.
We have passed
safari.
We have been to some places, but it's not like night. We didn't go.
It's a completely different
experience. Yes, different experience.
Try to do it.
Yeah, sure.
Inshallah. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
الفنون وثقافتها. تكلمنا عن بعض من أعمال الفنانة فيفي معنا. هنتكلم الحين عن ثقافة الفنون التشكيلية الهندية. Miss Veen, we know that India is a huge country.
Yes.
And there's a lot of areas between them. Give us the culture art of India, please.
Like you said that India is a big country and we have a lot of culture, like north side, south side. So I'm from south side of India, like Kerala.
Mm.
So when, I don't know, you have come.
I've been there, it's beautiful.
Yeah. So it's full of greenery. In most of my paintings, while I was doing in Kerala, it's like greenery. I will include because I'm seeing that one.
Mm.
So in my imagination, everything is coming like that. Actually, if I tell about the backstory of this painting,
mm-hmm.
like my grandma, she is living in a village. It's near to a forest. So we have to walk and it will take 2 kilometers from our house.
Okay.
So we will walk and go to grandma's house. So in between, in old days when I was small, so my cousins, everybody will be with me. So we will walk and we will tell stories. They're like imaginary stories. Like Hansel and Gretel is going to the forest, like breadcrumbs they will put and go to the forest, something like that. So we will go to grandma's house by walking. So my cousins will be there with me. So we will be telling like dream stories while we are walking to grandma's house. It's nearby a forest. So my cousins will tell, oh, there is a deer, there is a tiger, it's coming, like that, something.
So you put your imagination into the farm, is mashallah.
So it was like that.
When Karla is on the ocean, and when I visited, I've seen some greenery, but I could not imagine a forest of it.
Yeah.
Why didn't you give us some paints? I haven't seen that, if you don't, of the ocean.
Yeah, I have done ocean painting.
So I haven't seen it on your account of Instagram.
Yes, it's there in my book, like old books.
In the book?
Yes.
Not on the account.
You know. No, actually I will bring it now. Because you told my son and my sister's daughter, we were going to beach and all. That time I have took photos and have when I came home, I draw that one.
Oh,
I will show you that one.
Okay.
So this is the backstory of this painting. Mm-hmm. And I have added the deer. I didn't sow that deer while we were working. We were simply telling the deer, tiger will come like this. And we will think about Hansel and Gretel stories is there, no sir? Like Hansel and Gretel going to the forest. They will put breadcrumbs. That is a story.
Oh,
that's a famous story. So we will tell, we will talk like this and we will go there. So that is the dream about, that is the backstory of this painting.
I want to tell you, it's a beautiful thing when we have different cultures and art brought these arts and cultures together. I want to expose my deepest thank you to your family for giving us the time to be together. الفن أكثر من رائع. الفن يجمعنا ثقافات مختلفة من جميع أنحاء العالم. وهذا أجمل ما في برنامجنا ثقافة الفنون. فبإذن الله نقول لكم نشوفكم قريب. مع أحد فنانينا من وطن العربي أو من العالم كله. الفن يجمعنا. يومكم سعيد.